So first thing is that you rise with time, you sleep with time. So I always say that get up at 5. Whichever part of the world you are, get up at 5, 5:30. It makes a lot of a difference. If you get up at 5:30 or you get up at 6:30, get up at 5. Do not eat food 12 hours after you have woken up. So don't eat food after 6:30. Wherever part of the world you are, sometimes it is fine, you are going for some parties, vacations, fine. But make it an awareness that I won't be eating it for a major part of my life, you know. I'm going to follow this. It doesn't matter if you eat pizza, burger in that time. But don't cross the times. Eat at specific time. Third thing is do not drink water 50 minutes before 1 hour after you eat food. Because it dilutes it. It is given in Ayurveda. First thing, do not drink water. If you drink water with food, you're causing your system to go into disease. Whatsoever it might be. Do not drink water. Basic thing. It is applicable for everyone around the world. Earlier times, if you see most times, earlier times, they never used to serve water with food. They used to eat food, digest it, and then go. Maybe wine was there. Water was not there. Because wine has different properties. Water has different properties. So, don't drink it. Drink water only 50 minutes before. Drink as much as you can. Drink 1 hour after. Maybe 1.5 hours after. You're going to be really very specific. But don't drink.
Don't drink at all.
Don't drink at all. If you get a little bit like...
Like this. No, I was going to say, not necessarily water, but like anything.
No, that I'll come to later.
Okay.
So don't drink water. So this thing, you will give your body the perfect option to digest your food. It doesn't matter what you're eating. So these two things, simple things is eating on time, getting up on time, not drinking water. Third, having fixed timings for your food. These three things when you do, most of your disorders and inflammations are gone. You don't have to worry about anything. Fourth thing is that do not sleep through the day. Whenever possible, only go to sleep by as early as 9, 9:30, get up at 5. Do not sleep through the day. Lot of time when you sleep late night, you know, certain hormones in the bodies are not secreted. So it is causing problems in your body. So sleep when the body is about to cleanse itself. Whenever possible, I'm not saying it is possible all the times. But when you can make that choice, if you are suffering from some disorders where you are not making a head or tail, how exactly I'm going to get fit? I'm trying all these different things. I'm trying on the vegan diet, I'm trying gluten-free diet, I'm trying non-dairy, I'm trying this, nothing is happening. Just do this simple thing. For 7 days, 10 days, try it out. Women who are not losing weight, when I was in Pune, we did a lecture. So we told women, like, you know, just sleep by 9:30, get up at 5:30 and don't sleep through the day. Even by this simple thing, they lost like 10 pounds in 1 week, 1 month. Not doing any exercises, nothing. Just by sleeping on time, getting up on time. Women's body is so good. We won't lose, woman loses. Because your body has to structure itself each day for the egg. So it has got a lot of work on its head. It has to create menses, it has to create egg, it has to create food for the baby if it is not there again. So this goes every month, there is no escape. So you have got that chance to be healthy. As I told, that only few pages are written in Ayurveda about woman health. Why? Because this system is there. You can get deep into it. For us, it is a little bit different. But still it helps. So try and sleep on time. If you have got this inflammatory, autoimmune, whatever disorders, you will sleep on time. 80% will see complete difference within 1 week. So first thing is that, you know, get up before sunrise, don't eat after sunset, water don't drink, eat on time, sleep on time. Once this occurs, then you can think about other things, what you want to eat, what you don't want to eat. Few things are always things which cause a lot of gases, like peas, beans, don't eat them. They are only required by people who are doing like strong field work. You know, in earlier times, people used to work in fields, so crop, do farmers. For them, it is fine because it is true. For you, it will cause you lot of disturbances in the body. It will cause you gas, it will cause you digestive issues. So stay away from these things which causes lot of gas. Fourth thing, use salt sparingly. As I always tell people who come to consult me that, use salt before cooking your food. Never use salt while cooking or after cooking. So when you are putting your food on it, put salt then and then let it cook, and use always entire salt. Never use something which is created by man. Always use something which is created by nature. You get rock salt in nature. Use it. Don't use this free flow salts which contains all aluminium and all. It will cause you problems. So small, small things, as somebody asked me what we can do in our house. So get rid of all these things. Prepare, get these things in your house. Get good quality rock salt. Crush it, put it. Then cook whatever you want to cook. Soups, salads, what you want, doesn't matter. So this is one thing. Second thing I always talk is about utensils. Always use earthen utensils, earthenware. What do you call it? Earthenware, right? Clay.
Clay.
Clay utensils, clay pots. There are heat resistant clay pots. Earlier they were used to cook foods. You can support your local economy. A lot of time people say you want to be American, buy American. Look, support your local economy. There are a lot of people who are preparing it. If the demand rises, definitely you'll get it at a good rate. Prepare food. You see the quality of the food changes. It retains itself. A lot of time in my practice, I tell people not to eat yogurt. And they say, why are you telling not to eat yogurt? Because yogurt initially was prepared in clay pots. Nowadays, we don't prepare in clay pots. They're prepared in plastic containers, they're prepared in steel, and it causes poisons in your body. It causes toxins in your body. The same thing prepared in clay pot will work like elixir. Milk, if you boil it in clay pot, it will give you 10 times more benefit. It is the best anti-inflammatory you can ever have. A lot of people are saying, because we are taking dairy, we are getting inflammation. So this utensils also make a lot of a difference. If you don't get clay, use brass. If you don't get brass, then use bell's metal. I don't know what it is called in normal this, but it's from which the bells are prepared.
Iron.
No, iron is different. It's a little bit, it's a type of iron. But it is different. I'll give you the name afterwards, maybe once I remember it. If not, then use cast iron. Cast iron should be used sparingly, but if nothing is, then you can use glass. Nowadays you also get this glass in cooking. Use it. But don't use stainless steels, nickel, cadmium, aluminium, these things don't. You're pushing your children to autistic traits by using aluminium, by using nickel and cadmium. Because these are heavy metals which go into their body. It's not about other things. These small things should be taken care of. So use right kind of vessels. Initially, it will be a little bit difficult to cook in them. But once you get hang of it, it becomes easy. Third thing I always say in Ayurveda, it is said that never eat food to which sunlight and the wind is not exposed. So don't avoid using steamers and pressure items. Cook everything outside. In your kitchen, make a window where sunlight is coming, you know, or at least you're getting some kind of a light. So when it exposes to the food you're cooking, it enhances its qualities. The sunlight acts as a catalyst. The wind acts as a catalyst because it makes the food lighter and more digestible because you are everything but sun. The moment you put it in closed containers in pressurized environments, it becomes so difficult to digest. The same rice which you cook in a cooker and you cook outside, you will see difference. People who eat rice from pressure cooker, their blood sugar will spike. The same rice you cook it in earthen vessels, your sugar levels will be normal. So you can enjoy your food if you make this simple change. So these changes of utensils, of using salt, of drinking water, sleeping through the day, eating on time, sleeping on time, are the first basic changes which Ayurveda says which you have to make. Once you start making these changes, then lot of things change. Don't have to worry. It doesn't matter what you are eating. You are eating meat or eating vegetable, it doesn't matter. So this is the first level, kind of a food you get. So as we always say, sometimes this question always comes to me, is what is your opinion of GMO crops? You know, these crops. But as we always say that if people are becoming more and more vegetarian, then GMO crops are the way to go. You cannot create organic farming in small scale, in large scale. Organic farming is always done in small scale. If you have to do large fields of organic farming, it is not viable. The seeds do not there. Your own history is example to this. When I give the use of American history, in New England, initially when farming was done by the Britishers, they brought in the oxen and started farming. Your normal weeds, crop, grasses was done and new weeds were substituted, which fed your cattle, and therefore beef farming, dairy farming started. Then eventually men started, you know, cutting all your forest here, and they never replanted it. Till your Morrill Act came in 1887, when every university was granted an agriculture status, that the forest should be protected. It's your own history. It's not something which you have. So in fact, a lot of people, when I find it very amusing, when they blame the American government and they are supporting this, it was the government has stepped in to protect your forest. Therefore, you are at least getting some kind of a flora and fauna. Earlier, nothing was grown here. Only wheat was there. Some parts of corn was grown. During World War, your country became the largest exporter of soy, 73%. And when you put soybean in a field, after that 15 years, nothing grows. It becomes barren. It is a rule everywhere around the world. Soybean gives you the best crop, but once it is put, 15 years you sow it, after that the land becomes barren. So you have to put chemtrails. You have to make that soil viable to grow crops. And so that is the reason why the crop industry around the world, this industry started falling, because natural pulses, natural dyes, which were first a form of community farming, where people in their certain counties used to grow their vegetables, they used to supply it to the community, what was remaining they used to sell. This started going. We started giving it to big outlets who started importing it, giving it to you. So you started eating frozen food. Food was not, you know, earlier times people had to go in America 10 miles, 20 miles, 15 miles to a shop, get the grocery, store it in there. Therefore, you have these big refrigerators. There was no direct creation of food. People used to get this dough of wheat, put water in it, make it fermented for 7 days, 8 days, and then bread was created. Therefore, bread and cold cuts became your staple diet. Because it was cold, you cannot do anything in cold countries. You cannot grow crops. When certain times everything is covered under snow for 6 months, 7 months, what will you grow? So you have to understand this historical influences, why you are eating this. It is not suddenly you are going to go to India and think, oh, they are eating dal, they are eating fresh, we should eat this. No, you are adapted to this. You suddenly cannot change it. You will get inflammatory disorders, you will get problems. So this has to be transcended over a period of time. History always helps you understand how exactly these things happen. You don't require Ayurveda for it. So Ayurveda is just a system to make you understand, because this is mentioned in Ayurveda, what we call as Desh, Kal, how exactly different things happen in different parts of the regions. What is different part? So you have to understand what type of conditions you are staying, how exactly food was grown in your country. And when this bread, so now you are staying in this sustained controlled environments. You have this cooler, so whenever there is cold, you make it hot. Whenever there is hot, you make it cold. So these environments were never there earlier. So now when you have this environment, stop eating bread. Start creating pure dough. Bring the flour, put water, put oil, whatever it is, create the dough and eat it. You can have this meals in your house when you can grain. Buy whole grains. If you demand for it, initially it will be expensive, but once your demand grows, people will start supplying. Don't buy ready-made flours, even if it is certified, USDA certified, green, no. Because once you put flour on large scale, if you expose it to heat, everything goes. It doesn't matter if it is organically grown or inorganically grown. It loses its content. So bring it yourself, put it in your small instruments, create the flour, put some water, create your own, make different kinds of breads which are not fermented. So in this controlled environment, your gut will be proper. You know, we always say in Ayurveda that whatever you get, dementia, Alzheimer's is related to the gut. People never used to believe. Now there is this, I told in the previous lecture, now there is this research where they cut the vagus nerve if you are exposed to dementia, because they feel that the microbes travel through the vagus nerve to the brain to cause these problems, ALS, dementia, this. So see, it is written in Ayurveda. Once you eat fermented food, this food, it goes and sticks in your system. Body is unable to throw it out. It is not natural. It was natural in that time when you used to stay in very cold environment. So what happened? The internal heat was very strong. So you could digest it. Now it is not. But you are using the same things. You are cutting the cuts, you are putting it in controlled environment, you are bringing it, you are putting it in your fridge, in that weekend barbecue, you are putting that sauce and you are eating. Like we always say that people who suffer from gout, they always suffer from gout after the Thanksgiving. It is not because of the turkey, but because of the cranberry sauce. No, so these things people have to understand, that with the advent of these practices in this country where consumerism was at its highest, because even if we say you call it pseudo-capitalism or capitalism, you know, this country was created with a system that everyone has equal opportunity to earn their own living and live their dream. So consumerism was at highest. It was required to supply the growing needs of consumers who are ready to pay anything to get a good life. Because why you earn? You earn to have a good life. When you see the history, nowadays this awareness is coming, it is fine, but earlier it was not so. So everything was important, you know, because it was good brains, everything was got here, because nothing was grown here. And then this thing started. So you are using already frozen foods, which are already freezing it in your refrigerators, and you are eating. This causes all mental problems. This causes behavioral changes in your family. Children start becoming very cranky. Children start becoming very, you know, aggressive at birth. They start getting obesity. Their sweat starts smelling bad. They don't lose control over their urine. They become very panicky. You know, someone shouts at them, they become very regressive. We see these traits. Earlier it was not there. Now it is happening. Why? Because inflammation sets in. You are exposing them to this. The fourth curse was, after 1960s, the advent of refined sugar. So this refined sugar which came into, it got into each and every of your system. There was a time when America was consuming, it was a sugar bowl, you know, sugar consuming bowl of the world. Everyone was consuming so much sugar, that the sugar had to be, you cannot produce that much sugar in nature. You have to produce it in the factory. So refined sugar started coming. Everything of your confectionery had sugars. So there were cakes, everything what you eat was sugar. And then inflammatory diseases started. You passed on that genes to your children.
Mm.
You passed on that genes to everyone around. You did not suffer. So a lot of, I see women or aged women, they say in our times it was not there. We would eat everything. But you ate it. But you passed it on. So the next generation started getting this stuff. And that's how this thing started. So Ayurveda tells you that, you know, whatever is nature made, you use. You use jaggery. In India, we use gud or jaggery. It is made from the same cane sugar. But that jaggery, if you eat, it will increase your blood by 10 points. The same sugar what you eat from it, it will decrease your blood by 10 points. Same thing has got two different properties. If you eat sugar, body has to put all its resources to digest the sugar. If you eat jaggery, it will enable the body to digest whatever is eaten. So in India, after food was eaten, some jaggery was eaten, because it helped to digest the food. So one thing has got different properties. Like I said, the pomegranate juice you drink express will improve your eyesight. If you eat pomegranate, it will decrease your eyesight. So one thing, different properties. Some fruits are there, you should not be cutting it. You know, like I always, last lecture I was telling about this guava fruit. It's very good for the heart. But if you eat it like this, but if you put knife to it, if you cut it open, then it is going to cause blockages in your heart. But we see these fruit platters which we buy all the time. Some fruits are there which are cut by knife. And we eat it every day because we feel they are healthy. That also depends on how you are cutting the fruit. Some fruits, once any kind of metal is exposed to it, it starts oxidizing. It doesn't remain the same. But we are cutting it off. You are putting it in refrigerator. In the morning you are eating that fruit bowl. That also causes a problem. It causes this doshic change. It's not about what you are cooking, right? It's not about, you know, I'm using turmeric, so my vata will go down and putting. No. This is important. Everything is vayu pitta. So, not even using these spices, you can make these changes in your life. But this awareness has to be there. Therefore, when we go small, I had this lecture, I was telling them, support your community. You know, drink milk from your farm. You know, there are certain farms who give milk. Drink it. It is not bad. So if you get this good milk, it is the best anti-inflammatory. Nowadays people say there's some milk causes problem. It is because of the genetic mutations. We always talk about the A2 milk. Because 5,000-10,000 years when cattle were brooded from Asian subcontinent to the European subcontinent, some mutation occurred. So something happened in their 64th amino acid that purine got converted to histidine, so that became an avian milk. So when it goes, the body cannot synthesize it. It shows, gives lot of issues. But the Indian cows, what we call as the desi cows, what we get, which have got this hump, they make this A2 milk, which is very good for the body. And these cows are now sold in places like Mexico for like millions of dollars. You know, one cow is just one bull is of that species to mate. Because here also a lot of indigenous cow came. Here a lot of cows were not there. So indigenous cows came, the Jersey, the Holstein. There are a lot of breeds here, the Brahmos, of which there is a Gersney cow, what I call, which comes from Germany. It gets yellowish milk. Use that milk. It's very good milk. If not, use goat's milk. If you're not vegan, you know, a lot of people don't drink milk. But if they milk, I always advocate it. Give it to your children initially. Don't deprive them of it. A lot of people say it is some other animal's milk. But it is not. Because in a cow there are 5 udders. The calf only drinks from 2. If you don't take out that milk, in India it is in Ruksha Ayurveda, it develops tumors. You have to take out that milk. That does not mean you put it to a machine and you take out, but you have to. Calf cannot drink the whole milk. So some things have been provided in nature for you. So use it. So though then you can say you are natural. You are using something from what is going on. Once you make this point to point changes, then lot of disorder starts diminishing from your life.